Hello everyone, let's get started with exercises from the first session. In the first session, we covered this code. We were not able to cover the length statement and we were not able to cover the title statement, but we can put it aside for a later time. For the time being, for those of you who are not well versed with SAS execution, I want you to observe something, why the length statement has been mentioned here. Now, if you observe that we have three variables in that are responsible for this data. The first variable is name, which is carrying these pieces of information: Thomas, 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 Wu Wu, Walters, Christopher Sun, three times. Now, if you observe, Thomas is 6 letters, Wu is 2 letters, Walters is 7 letters, and Christopher Sun is almost 16 letters. If I were not to execute this line, let us temporarily remove it. And let's only execute this code and see what happens. Please observe that Thomas, Wu, Walters, all three names are printed okay. But when it comes to Christopher Sun, it is getting truncated here. The word is truncated. So we have to avoid this. For that reason, we are going to use the length statement. By default, SAS is going to only use 8 memory spaces for each and every name. So if you want to overtake that or overcome that, we are going to use the length statement. The length statement here not only creates a variable in PDV, the program data vector, but it also allocates a necessary memory space as allocated or as written or as mentioned here. Let's try to run this code once again and see the result. There you go. The word Christopher Sun is now completely printed, and this is exactly what we needed. Now, there is another part to this. We need to take this data, paste them inside Excel, and use that Excel data to be imported into our R session. How are we going to do that? Let's get to that right now. Here is the data well arranged for us. How did we get here? We copied and we pasted the data here, and then we simply clicked the under the data tab, text to columns. Click on next. And here is how the arrangement of your data is required to be as. And then we say finish. There you go. You have the data ready. As simple as this. Now let's import this data into our R session. This very same data in this under this file name has been placed in Dropbox, and the link for the same has been placed in the description for you. Please refer to the description. This was the section of code that we had seen in the first series. Now, instead of typing all of this data, we are going to use a simple code that will help us to import the Excel data. Let's see that in action. All right. So here I have already typed the code out for you so that I will be able to focus on explaining the code, not on typing the code. So as we discussed, we need to import data from Excel, and I have already created my Excel sheet. The sheet is already posted in the description for you. Before we get into importing data, I want you to look into something called as a package. Now, what is a package? It contains something. Let us put it that way. It is not empty, but it contains something. And interestingly, when it is a package in R, it contains something that is useful for the functionalities of R programming. The equivalent in SAS is the word macro. Macro is always denoted by a percentage. Why would they use a percentage symbol in SAS macro? Simply put, if I have to say 7% of the world's population. Now, 7% of world's population would be 7% of the 7 billion people, or so on and so forth. That means the percentage symbol implies something greater. It carries within it the capacity to represent those parameters and functionalities that does not have to be listed out or spelled out for us. But in simple words, macro contains a lot more functions for us to use than we can imagine with that simple code. Let's, for example, look into one such package. In SAS, you would address it as macro. In R, you would address it as a package. Now, let's just keep our understanding about package or macros in SAS for the time being till here, because the functionalities and the applications are totally different. How to install a package? We use the code install.packages, and here I would like to install a particular package known as gdata. And inside the brackets, I am going to mention my parameters. So the first parameter is placed within double quotes. Always place the package name in double quotes, followed by a comma if there is another argument. So here the other argument being dependencies is equal to true, which simply implies that this package gdata might be requiring certain other mini packages which are useful for its function in its completeness. So that is exactly what we are doing right now. We are saying dependencies is equal to true, which means kindly install all the other required packages also, which are in tune with gdata. I have just now answered this question. The next question is how to call upon any installed package, or if you have already installed a package, it will be there in your memory. And if you just want to call it, how would you do that? There are two options for that. One is you can either use the word or the function require and say require package. As you see, it is executed here. Or you can also use the word library and simply say, just get this library for me. Now, I'm sorry I have not mentioned as to why I have been using hash symbol here followed by these lines or comments. As you have understood, any programmer would understand this, that you are trying to just place some comments for the user to understand. So hash followed by any line would null the execution of it as a code and would be taken as a comment. That's why you see them highlighted in green. The next question: how to read the Excel data using functions which are inside the installed package? That means this package called gdata contains within itself embedded functions that are designed to execute various functionalities and an analysis. So here I'm going to create again the sales data set which we saw in the first session. I'm going to say read this Excel file, which is placed in this particular path, please place them inside double quotes. I'm going to use the first worksheet, and so I'm going to name it as sheet is equal to 1. Or in case if I have a name for that worksheet, for example, if the worksheet is named as AAAA, just simply place them in double quotes and say AAAA. Else, simply say the first worksheet. Simple, isn't it? And then mention for sure header is equal to T or true. You can use both the words. R will understand and assume that when you say T, it is true. Or when you say F, it is false. So remember that. Why are we saying header is equal to true? When we mention that header is equal to true, it means that the first line or within, that is the first row in the mentioned worksheet, is carrying data which are variable names. This is very, very important. Next, I have explained, I have answered this question. What is the content inside the brackets? What if there are multiple sheets? Let's go ahead and execute it. Let us go ahead now and view the sales data that we have just now successfully created. There you go. Three variables and our respective data. As I have mentioned to you that if it was SAS, it would have truncated the word Christopher as Christop, because it will only take by default 8 characters. Fine, we will come back to that. Is there another way to have a look at our data? Quite simple. Select this code and simply envelope them in another pair of brackets. Can you see a fresh pair of brackets here and here? Now, run this code. In the console section, you can directly see the result of your data sets instead of using the view command here. You can directly look at the data. This is a very nice option in case if your data is small with less number of variables, a smaller matrix at the maximum a few variables and maybe 10 observations, just like this. If it is many variables and too much, then I don't think that would be a good idea at all. But there is another way in case if you just want to have a glance at your data set. Let us use the head command and say sales. Let's see what happens then. This option gives me the opportunity to look at all my variables but only 6 lines of observations. If there is a head, there should be a tail. Let's try that. Again, I see all the variables except from the reverse, it is counting 6 observations and it is printing the output as such. Simple tips. We will get more understanding as we go and learn these little tricks day by day. It will become fun to type code and not time consuming and tasking. Thank you for watching. Do subscribe to my channel to get more notifications on newer videos.